News review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we give you the words and expressions you need to talk about the news. Hi, I'm Neil, and joining me today is Sean. Hi, Sean.
Hi, Neil.
So, what's the story you've got for us?
Today we have a health story about something that causes illness in humans but cannot be cured.
Something that causes illness in humans that cannot be cured. Mm-hmm. Sounds serious. Let's find out more from this BBC World Service News Bulletin.
Health officials in the United States say a superbug resistant to all known antibiotics has been found in the country for the first time. The case involves a woman infected with a strain of the E-coli bacteria resistant to Colisten, an antibiotic of last resort.
So, scientists in America have found a new superbug, which is a bacteria that causes illness in humans and can't be cured with antibiotics.
All right. Well, you've been looking around the news media, the websites, and what are the words you found that we need to understand this story?
Okay. So, I found three words, and they are superbug, nightmare, and drug-proof.
Okay, so that's superbug, a type of bacteria that cannot be treated using antibiotics. Nightmare, here, meaning terrible. And drug-proof, meaning resistant to drugs. So you've been looking around, and how are these being used in the headlines, Sean?
Okay, so the first headline I found is from Forbes, and it is dreaded superbug found for first time in US patient. A physician's perspective.
Right, so superbug, made up of two words there, super and bug. Bug, that's an insect, isn't it?
It can be an insect, but here it definitely does not mean insect. Here it means, bacteria that causes, or virus that causes an illness.
I see, and super. Now that, I'm also confused here, that means great, wonderful, doesn't it?
It can mean great or wonderful, but it definitely doesn't mean that here. Mm. So as a prefix here, it means larger or more powerful than normal.
Okay. And can you give me some other examples of words containing that use of super?
So, for example, if we describe someone as superhuman, they are more powerful than your average human.
Ah.
So maybe they fly or they can run very fast.
Okay. And another one?
For example, supernatural is another one we can use. So something which is above and beyond what exists in nature.
Ghosts.
Ghosts, exactly.
Okay.
Mind reading, that kind of thing.
Talking of ghosts, our next expression, next word.
Okay, so the next word is nightmare. And in CNBC, they have this headline, nightmare bacteria superbug. Found for first time in US.
Right, so, nightmare. I had a nightmare last night.
Oh dear.
Yeah, some aliens came down, smashed my window, took me into space. I never saw anyone again.
Sounds supernatural and scary.
But that was a bad dream.
Mm.
But this thing you're talking about is not a bad dream, is it? It's real.
So, no.
So why nightmare?
Well, a nightmare is a bad, scary dream. But we also use the word nightmare as a noun or an adjective to say that describe something as very, very bad.
Right.
So terrible.
Have you had a nightmare recently?
Not recently. I sleep pretty well, generally.
Yeah, but how about your journey in this morning?
Ah, that kind of nightmare. I have had a nightmare journey. Yeah. So not when I was sleeping, but this morning I had a nightmare journey into work.
It was delayed.
All the trains were cancelled. It took me 3 hours instead of two, which is a nightmare anyway.
What a nightmare.
It is a nightmare.
And we can say nightmarish as well to describe that.
Yes, we can also say that.
All right, your final headline then.
Okay. So the final headline is from PBS NewsHour. New superbug becomes first drug-proof bacteria to hit US.
Okay, drug-proof.
Mm-hmm.
What's all that about?
Okay, so drug meaning medicine here. And proof, the suffix proof, means resistant to or protected against.
Right.
So this bacteria is resistant to medicine.
It's drug proof.
Drug proof.
Right. I like hiking. Did you know that?
No, I didn't know that, but that's interesting.
If you go hiking in this country, especially in the north, it rains a lot. So I need to wear...
So you need to wear waterproof clothing to protect you from the rain.
Yeah, and the wind. So
windproof clothing also.
That's right, that's right. Police officers who go into dangerous areas with lots of gun crime, what do they need to wear?
Okay, so if they need protection from the bullets, from guns, they would need to wear a bulletproof vest.
Okay.
To save their life.
Yeah. Here's my favourite, proof. I bought a piece of furniture that needed to be constructed by me.
Oh, congratulations.
The instructions were very simple. There weren't even any words, just little diagrams. It was so clear that even an idiot like me could do it.
They were idiot-proof instructions.
They were idiot-proof instructions.
And did it work? Did you build your furniture?
Actually, no. I don't think they found an idiot of my scale.
No comment.
Okay. Let's find out more about this story from the BBC's Laura Bicker.
The female patient tested positive for a strain of E. coli that's resistant to the antibiotic known as Colisten. The US Centre for Disease Control and Prevention said it was an old antibiotic, but the only one left to treat what they described as a nightmare bacteria. Researchers are worried that the antibiotic-resistant gene found in the bacteria, known as MCR1, could easily spread. That could create a superbug capable of evading all types of antibiotics. The deadly strain has already been found in China and Europe. Officials say unless there's urgent action and more research, some infections could eventually become untreatable.
The BBC's Laura Bicker there using the expression nightmare and also... superbug, which is what we're talking about. It's our Facebook challenge, and we asked this simple question about the word proof that we've been looking at. What does dog proof mean?
Yes.
What have we heard?
We had lots of responses to this question. The majority of people said, gave the answer B. So dog proof means dogs can't be harmed by it. But we also had a lot of people who gave the answer A. So meaning dogs can't harm it. So which one is correct?
Well, we were looking for answer A, dogs can't harm it. For example, a ball that a dog can chew up as much as it likes, but it still doesn't fall apart. That's what we were thinking of. But actually, it could be the other as well. So I think this time, everyone's a winner.
So everyone got the answer correct.
That's right.
Well done.
Okay, Sian, can you just give us a short summary of the language we looked at today?
Okay, so we looked at three words. Superbug, a type of bacteria that cannot be treated using antibiotics. Nightmare, meaning terrible, very, very bad. And drug-proof, meaning resistant to drugs.
Well, we hope this programme hasn't been a nightmare for you. For more help with your English, go to bbclearningenglish.com. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
News review from BBC Learning English.